Hey guys, Rick Repairs, and welcome back to my Liverpool Career Mode, where last time I left off, I sent a couple matches, and, well, ta-da! After simming the matches I simmed in the last episode, I have secured the sixth consecutive league title. As you can see, I have, with 7 games remaining, whereas Chelsea, my closest challengers, there's on 62 points, have played a game more, or on 32. Which means they can't even get the 20 points that would need to catch me. He, especially considering I can get 21 points. Even if they could get 20 points, I could get one extra. So, even if they could get the 20 points somehow, you know, it's actually impossible. Because even if they won all their remaining matches, that would only be 18 points. I can get 21. So, who you are? In the remaining episodes, I will not show you any of the league matches. They're all going to be simmed off camera. The last one you are going to see is Manchester United in this episode, because you know, have to beat them to keep the streak going. Because there by levels a streak and never want them to end. So this is going to be the last league game of FIFA 15 for Liverpool full career mode. Now it will return, of course, in FIFA 16 with all the improvements. And of course, it does. We'll be playing at some new stadiums like Carrow Road, Bournemouth Stadium. I'm not sure what it's actually called. I'm sorry, Bournemouth fans. I don't know what your stadium is called. Well, if any Bournemouth fans watching, please tell me what the name of your stadium is in the comment section below. And Vicarage Road of Watford. So those stadiums will be in the game next FIFA. If anyone knows, are the stadiums of the relegated teams staying in FIFA, or are they going to be removed? So, like, will the KC Stadium, the Turf Moor, and Loftus Road, will they all still be in FIFA next week now, or are they going to be just removed? If you guys know, or if it even is known, then let me know in the comment section below, as well as the name of Bournemouth Stadium, so I know what it is. I know Liverpool are actually playing Bournemouth this Monday. Well, obviously, it's yesterday when you see this, because this goes up on Tuesday, but it's recorded beforehand, so. Don't comment the result, because I'll know by the time this goes up. I'll made it my second Premier review video anyway, so. You'll hear my thoughts on all the games, including Manchester United's another narrow win for Manchester United over Aston Villa. I won't give my thoughts yet, so I'll keep that until Monday night. After the Bournemouth-Liverpool game finishes, then you will hear what I thought of all the games, not just Liverpool. It's a new thing I'm tracking. I enjoyed the first episode of the Prem Review, and I've working on getting that thumbnail done. Let's see if that if I can get that. Good deal. So while I may sound like I'm in a good mood, it's only because the match hasn't happened yet. Can their car get there? Or the heck, can't pick that up? It's her way over the park. Oh, God, say. Carne! Ooh. Looks like it was saved by De Gea's elbow. Interesting tactic of saving the ball. Continue! Blind! Wasn't blind to where the ball was, but oh, Carne puts it in anyway. My team is tired. What the hell are they tired from? Oh
boy. Oh.
And they are making a substitution to bring out Chicharito. They screen with Kachanga and Torbe. He will have got the ball back. Go on one. Go on one. Ryan. Gote. Torbe. Royce. Boom. And Torbe doesn't get an assist. Oh, man. Oh, whoops. That was a terrible ball. My bad. Straight ahead, I'm broke. Royce! Another offside goal. Oh, it's going well. It is going well. There we go. A nice, good tackle. Hold that from Kim Holmes. Who scored Man United's goal. Oh shit! Speaking of Man United goals, I think that's Vargas. Yeah, it was. Shit, I didn't see that coming. And, oof! Almost struck back immediately. Go for it again, outside. Off the bar again? Because I had no idea where you were going. You were way out of position. Props. Wow, that was a terrible. I don't know where I was trying to pass it or shoot it. I hit circle, so I'm going to go with shoot. So that was a terrible shot. Yeah, I should have crossed instead. I'm going for war. Oh. There we go, another good tackle by Matty Hummels. I will attack the zone, the big crab. Corny!
Yes!
Should I put Cardi to number 9? I don't suppose it's worth it, is it? For only a couple of games? Maybe I should have given him the number 9 at the start of the season. I don't know why I'm just thinking of this now. It doesn't matter. It's a 4-1 win. Streak is intact. We'll go into FIFA 16. And it will go into FIFA 17. And 18. And 19. And 20. And 21. And 22. And 23. And 24. And 25. And 26. 27. 28. And 29. That's 30. Yeah. It will go forever. Never end. It will never, ever end. 39 rounds. Just has to be done. Just has to be done. Anyway, from Hunt, he might. Love to another. Full use. I mean, Southampton. My mistake. Very similar teams. Practically identical right now. Oh, see, even I can do it. I absolutely hate the fact. Even though Klein was alright in the first game, I still hate the fact that we're pretty much only buying Southampton players. They don't have players like Messi. So, although, if Barcelona's result has... I record this on Saturday, just so you know. But if Barcelona's result last night, they ain't go by. Yeah, I don't want anyone from Barcelona. Anyway, that's not anything Barcelona fans should be concerned about, because really it's the Spanish Community Shield. Who really gives a shit? The fact that Barcelona even play Messi and Suarez confuses me. They kind of seem to care, but they don't really care because they let that 4-0 happen. Or maybe they just didn't play well enough. Oh. Both are equally possible. But only the first one really makes sense. I mean, how can Barcelona go from winning practically everything there is to win to losing 4-0 to a team that finished midway in the table or something like that last season? And why is Athletic Bilbao in the, why are they in the Super Cup? Shouldn't it be Real Madrid? Is Real Madrid for a second, last I checked? Or is it different to how... Is it different to how England's Community Shield, where is... If the league winners also win the cup, the runners-up of the cup get spot. Is that how it works? Because that's kind of stupid. You guys. Anyway, I guess I should talk about the match. A 4-0 now. So the final, that's a thing that's gonna happen, because I'm gonna be there. I think it's pretty safe to assume I will be in the final. Who will be there with me? Because I have absolutely no idea who is in the other semifinal. You think I'd tabs on that, but no, not really. I don't give a shit.
It could be anyone from all I care. Considering I've scored 8 goals already in this episode, I'm not even halfway through this match.
Yeah, not really worried.
I was just about to say, isn't that a foul? I was just about to say, we're really like half an hour to go. Oh, that's incredible, Lancey. How the hell did he keep that in? I didn't even think I'd keep that in. I'm not amazed. I haven't been in the semi-finals, wow.
Promising sign if that's any indication of how they'll do in the Europa League in real life. No, promising sign if you're a Saints fan. Not so much if you're a Liverpool fan, because we're in that too. You know, I think the Bournemouth match will show whether we're serious about top four or not. Because we always seem to struggle against the promoted teams. Because they always seem to catch us somewhere.
Okay, every single season. Getting really, really frustrated.
if we beat Bournemouth, and now that's just, that's it, touch wood, I think we'll be in good form heading into our match with Arsenal, who is afterwards. And again, not looking ahead, not looking past Bournemouth in any way or form, because that's how you lose with matches like that. Is that a Lansing match? I think it is. It doesn't matter. How we play against Bournemouth will pick how we do this season, I think. If we play well and beat Bournemouth again, if we can have a good season. If we perform poorly against Bournemouth and lose, hopefully not, touch wood. Then our season could be, as we hope it won't, an absolute shambles. I mean, I think Brendan Rodgers needs to take a look at what happened at the end of the Stoke game. It seemed like from the minute he brought him on, and even if he isn't 100% fit, it seems like he changed the game. I don't know. Maybe it was just a coincidence. But Firmino seemed to change the game. He seemed to change the game. I don't know why he is. Dark again. And Stoke, they were saying on Sky Sports News or somewhere that he wasn't 100% fit. Actually, no. That wasn't. No, it wasn't Sky Sports News. Comments below. Cool. So, yeah, thanks to Poet and David for telling me that. I actually did not know who Firmino was unfit. No mention of it when we signed him. If there was, I was too excited to care. At least start him. You know, he doesn't have to play the whole 90 minutes if he's not fit. You know, at least play him up until like the 65th minute or something like that. Get him into the feel of starting a permanent match, because he's going to become a starter as soon as he is 100% fit, guaranteed. Especially if he maybe. Now again, maybe I'm wrong, maybe he didn't change the game, maybe, like I said, it was a pure coincidence, but, hey, if it wasn't a pure coincidence, then I don't care. He seemed to play well as well. Well, it looked like he was right in the Prem League, and that's not something that happens often. You know, players don't automatically gel. That's the problem with buying foreign talent, because you don't know if they're gonna adapt to the Prem League straight away, like you would hope. But Firmino, from what I saw against Stoke, it looked like he didn't have any problem. You know. He seems like a very friendly person at that. You know, well, he committed a foul at one point and pretty much said, okay, I did foul. Most players would be like, what? No, it was him. It was him. It was that guy over there. For sure. It wasn't me at all. Well, But for me, he held up his hands and he was like, okay, I did it. I'm sorry. It won't happen again. So that was weird. That's not something you norm. That's not something you're seeing in from the player who admits to making a mistake. That's rare for a Liverpool fan. We just got through who the Luis Suarez period of we're used to someone saying he didn't do it when he actually did. Not owning up to his mistake. Like Firmino did for that challenge. Maybe Villa and Spurs. Okay. Maybe I'm mad to think he changed the game. Maybe he didn't. Maybe he did. I don't know. Oh, and that could have been Man United. Look, Southampton beat Man United. So it's between Spurs and Villa to see who I will play in the final. Get over it, Marco. It was one freaking match. Jeez. You think I hadn't played him all season? I'd like to play, please. I play every single match. But I'd like to play this one. It's not much. And I'm like, seriously? Spurs. Okay, Spurs. So in the next sort of, I will have two matches against the blue side of Manchester. Or Manchester City. Until then, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy.